Hello there. On this tutorial, I want to show you how to handle third-party dependencies through Boost through Webpack. And right now, my third-party dependency is on Bootstrap. As you can see, I am adding it here through a link tab. This is a common way to add third-party dependencies on your browser. It will be similar things here on the script. I could use CDNs or use reference to local files on my server. But through Webpack is different. So let me begin by removing this here, and let me show you something in my package JSON file. You can see that we have been storing here our dependencies, the one that we have been installing through npm installs, but they are the dependencies. Since I have been using the flag dep dependency every time I have installed anything through npm, and right now we need to add a real dependency. So what is the difference between dev dependencies and normal dependencies? You could think about it like the dev dependencies are things that you only require for development. So things like Webpack, we require only for development. If we were to install a unit test framework such as Jest or Mocha, that will also be a dev dependency. But Bootstrap is a normal dependencies, and you can think about normal dependencies like runtime dependencies, things that your web page actually need in order to be able to function properly. So let's see how we can install Bootstrap through Webpack. We are going to come to the official page on Bootstrap, and then we are going to go into the get started section, and we are going to come here, and you can actually see that they have a Webpack section. And many of the libraries that you will probably see on the web, they will have Webpack support since Webpack is so popular. And actually for many of them, they will expect you to have Webpack in place. So you can see here it's telling us how to import Bootstrap, and actually it's telling us how we can import individual plugins. But we actually need to install it first, so I'm going to come here. And here you will find the common npm install that we have been using. So I will bring this to my terminal and I will run this. And you can see that I am not using --savedet like I was in the other. And actually before npm version 5, I will have to specify here with --save so that this will be saved into my package JSON. But since version 5, that is no longer necessary. But just know that running npm install Bootstrap will be storing this as a normal dependency. If I want it as a dev dependency, then I do have to specify my flag. So let's run this. Now that that is done, you can see that Bootstrap has been added as a dependency here and not in dev dependencies. So let's see how we can actually import it now. Let's go back into the documentation, and you can see that it's telling me here that I can import Bootstrap JavaScript by adding this line to your app's entry point. And this will add the entire Bootstrap. It's also telling me how to add individual JavaScript plugins, but I am actually not interested in JavaScript right now, at least not the JavaScript from Bootstrap. I just want the styles. And here it's telling me how I can bring the precompiled SAS styles, but right now I just need CSS styles. Since I am not planning to do any customization to Bootstrap to the SAS files, so I'm going to bring the CSS. I will have it here in my entry point, and I actually have to respect the order like I do when using normal CSS files. So I want Bootstrap first and then my site CSS. Let's see what else the documentation said. And you can see that it's telling me to add a rule for CSS files and to use the If I am not using SAS, I need to add style loader and CSS loader. I actually already installed these two as a prerequisite, but I don't have a rule for CSS file. So I will bring this rule here into my module. And I actually just need this part since I have already added the rules section to my Webpack config. So let me bring it into my Webpack config, and I will add it here as another rule. Again, I will apply some formatting, and that is looking good. So right now, let's just see my application how it's doing. Since I have removed Webpack, since I have removed Bootstrap from my layout, and I haven't run Webpack, I will expect my application to be, the styles are not correct right now. So let's run Webpack and see if that will fix it. So let's clean the terminal here and let's run npm run build. And let's hope that that has fixed my styling. And you can see that Bootstrap is now back in place, but now it's being added as an explicit dependency in my entry point. Now we need to address another thing. Right now we have been using a single entry point, which is my home JS file, and we are producing this home bundle JS file. And we are referring that only in my home page. That means that my search page does not have any styling right now. I could simply move this script reference to my layout, and that way I will have in all of my pages the styling. And that's one way I could fix that. I could fix this, but what I want to do is to have multiple entry points and multiple bundles, because I want to be able to separate my common things for all of the pages, my specific files for my homepage, and my specific file for my search file for my search page. So on the next video, I will be looking into how to use multiple bundles and multiple entry points in Webpack. I hope you will join me on my next video.